One of the great joys I have from card making is how flexible it is to suit our individual styles. The same stamp set can be used by someone with ultra clean and beautiful style, such as the designer of this stamp set, Kathy Zilski, and equally by the lover of rainbow colours, Laura Bassen, and also myself with my love of water mediums. This card started out in my head when I was sat in my garden the other day, and I noticed subtle changes such as the poppy leaves dying back, with just the seed pod heads bobbing around. In fact, there are more seeds than flowers in my garden at the moment. We are also drawing the curtains earlier too, and it's all those signs that the seasons are about to change. Anyway, it was those poppy heads that got me thinking. They are starting to dry out nicely and will form a lovely structure to the garden as autumn comes around. The colours change too, don't they, from those fresh greens and floral colours to deeper greens and yellows. The fields are ready for haymaking and crops are ripening, and it was this combination of structure and colour that had me reaching for Kathy's Silhouette Sentiment Set. The botanical silhouette image was perfect for what I had in mind. Before I started stamping, I watercoloured a loose wash of colour over the background. I taped a piece of Fabriano Artistico Extra White Cold Press watercolour card to a board to prevent it warping. I then added plenty of water so that as I added the paint, the watercolours gently blended together to give a lovely soft base on which to stamp. I used a mix of yellow ochre, undersea green and Piemontite Genuine from Daniel Smith. I finished off with a splash of water to get everything moving and gently tipped the board so that gravity would join in too with getting those colours blending and mixing in an interesting way. I dried off the piece before removing the tape and moving it to the Mini Misty. I align the silhouette image over the left side. I wish now I'd placed it a little higher for this first impression, but I do go back in later on to fix that. Sorry, as I'm trying to voice over this, my daughter's dog is just sighing in the background, so I apologise if you keep hearing noises. Anyway, what I was going to say is, I think it looks good to have a natural flow to the line of the tops of the botanicals. So my aim was to work in a diagonal with higher florals on the left working down to the right. Nothing too dramatic, just not straight across. I added paint with a brush using the same colour palette as I had for the background. And then I spritz liberally with water using the Tim Holtz sprayer. Did you know that things in the distance appear paler than those in the foreground? As such, I kept my first layers light and with lots of water spritz onto them. Then slowly I built up the depth of colour as the plants came closer. So those first layers were really loose and watery. And then after I'd stamped four times or so and then got a good base for the distant images, I came back in with another layer. This time I use slightly less water as I stamped. The paint is therefore more concentrated and the colours deeper. When I stamped the second time for this layer, I hadn't used enough water and the image was a bit blotchy. But that is the joy of the Misty in that you can come back in again to fix it. Without adding in any more paint, I spritzed the stamp with more water and stamped again until I was happy. I dried off this layer and then pulled out my distress inks. For the final layer, I want more definition than I think I can get with the paint, but I know I can get that from distress inks, and because they are water reactive, I equally know they will fit in well with this loose watercolour. To match my colour scheme, I bought in antique linen, forest moss and brush corduroy. However, as I start to stamp, I realised that the antique linen was a bit pale, and so I replaced it with scattered straw. I stamped the image in exactly the same way as I had for the watercolour paints, adding colour, a light spritz of water, not too much for this foreground layer so that it was more defined. The only difference is that to have more room to stamp the image lower down, I switched to the bigger Misty. I have a palette with some dried white gouache, which I reactivate with water on a brush whenever I want to add my favourite splatter. I kept the mix quite watery so that I would have bigger, looser splotches of paint. I also splattered over the distant layer with yellow ochre. My aim with this was to give that hazy effect that you often see with autumn fields. I dried the panel and then set it aside while I worked on the sentiment. Often I add a simple white embossed sentiment on black card or a pre-printed sentiment strip in the same style that you can get from Simser Stamp. However, when I experimented, black was too harsh for these warm fall colours, and so I created my own matching card. I used cold press watercolour card on this occasion as the smooth texture is easier to stamp on for the clean lines I wanted for a greeting. I painted a deep green base and then stamped a white heat embosser greeting from the Hibiscus Bloom set. I trimmed this to a skinny strip using a craft knife, a clear gridded metal edge ruler on a self-healing cutting mat. And then before adding the sentiment strip though, I wanted to add a bit of twine. I kept things simple with Mayotte's twine wrapped around the panel twice and secured on the back with painter's tape. I arranged the twine so that the two lines intersected where I wanted to add the greeting. I added foam tape to the back of the panel and then added it to a card base, cut and scored from ivory card. I also added foam tape to the back of the sentiment strip and used a T-square ruler to help me align it on straight. To finish, I added ice sherbet sequins combined with eggshell pearls, and both of those are from Little Things from Lucy's Cards, which I kept in place with Gina K Connect glue. And so there you go, my take on a loose fall watercolored card. The overall design is simple, with just a little twine and a clean sentiment strip, but equally there is lots of watery goodness going on in that background too. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I will leave links to the products that I've used today in the video description. I do appreciate your support in using these links to help me keep creating videos to share. I'll also leave a link to the blog post where you'll find more details too. Oh, and finally, there's that subscribe button if you want to give that a click to follow along with what's to come. And this is an exciting time of year in the card making calendar, with Stamptember just around the corner. Okay, that's me for this time. Thanks for joining me, and I'll see you next time.